Hi everyone, my name is Prakar. I'm here from Common Floor to demo our map search to you guys. So Common Floor is basically a real estate online portal where we focus on three main needs of the Indian real estate consumer. Namely, they are buying, selling and renting of properties and helping apartments manage themselves and some real estate content, articles and things like that. So let me get straight to the demo. Where would you guys like to stay in Bangalore? Whenever you choose a place to stay, you always think of some place related to your office or whichever place you keep going visiting again and again. So the normal property search that we had, this was the main problem that people could not visualize, especially people who are coming new to the city of Bangalore, like say for example our friend over here. So our map search puts all the properties on the map which make visualization very easy. So let me start with the demo. Alright, so as you see, it's pretty simple. We've got a very small form over here for sale, for rent, city and locality. So once you select a city, like right now I've selected only Bangalore. So then it tells me the overall bird's eye view. So as I keep zooming in, it keeps dividing that one place into multiple zones and regions that we have. So when you go on each of these, you can see how many properties are available. So suppose I clicked on one of them. Okay, the net is pretty slow. Okay, let me take this example over here. So this is zoomed in into one of the regions. So as you can see, this is a polygon where we actually demarcate the area, that this is where the area lies. And if you click on any one of these, again, it keeps zooming in until it finally reaches the actual property or the apartment. So like as you can see over here, we have a lot of data related to apartments. So we group the properties to the actual apartment. So if there are multiple properties in an apartment, they'll all come as one marker. See two apartments, and similarly, so like that you can use this and open the full listing detail page. That's where all the information about that listing is available. So as I said before, the apartment information is also there, so you can correlate to the nearby places that are there and what are the amenities available in the apartment. Especially for a new person who doesn't know anything about the area, so suppose say he's joined in ITBL. So he comes and he knows only that Whitefield exists and he has to find a place which is close by to his office. So using this map search, he's easily able to point out and figure out like, okay, school is here, my child will go to the school, so I need to find a place which exists between these two. It becomes very simple rather. Search for Whitefield right now. Most of our geo data comes from Google. We use reverse geocoding and things like that. So there are errors like Belandur is marked inside the lake. So, I mean, this is just the first iteration. And since we met a Google personnel over here, so we're trying to build up. The net is too slow, there's no point. I think you guys got the gist of it. Thank you. Any questions?
So how did you get this data? Yeah,
like I said, we have a large database of apartments. And for the apartments, our own data team maps the geocode. And once we find out that the listing actually exists in that apartment, we use the apartment geocode to put the listing over there.
And you find the apartment geocode from the map?
From the map, yeah.
It's
a manual process. Yeah, correct. And we also use Google's reverse geocoding. So that sometimes tends to not give such accurate results.
So why don't you ask the apartment developer to use use an Android phone or something.
There are, like I said before, Common Floor has multiple things. One of the things is helping apartments manage themselves.
Right.
So we have our own software which helps manage their internal things. So once an apartment comes to that stage, then we add a lot of data regarding it, like floor plans and things like that. So along with that, the geocode is also there.
To answer your question, there is a lot of information we actually get from a listing when a person puts in a listing, including the geocode of the apartment that he stays in. So we have a process where we actually sort of take that feedback and then sort of supply it and push it into our database.
Yeah, so the question is, if you are using an automated geocoder to upload the geocode from another, it's likely not going to be more accurate. So if the user records that, it's very easy to make a place marking like my map.
We have that also. When the user is posting a listing, he can choose its position on the map. That's also.
So you can just browse in a particular area.
Yeah.
Any other variants which I can search?
I mean, not exactly. You can search directly. You can type the name of the locality or the apartment, and you can go directly to that place. Also, if you zoom out to the, say, country level, then you can see a whole lot of data, as in which cities have how many listings. But obviously, these are only what we have. It's very, very slow. So this 10,000 that you see is Bangalore, this is Chennai, and these are all other small cities with sale listings as of now.
What's the technology stack that you guys
got? We use Apache Solr in the backend. That's a search engine. It supports GeoHash and things like that, but as of now, this implementation does not use GeoHash.
Okay, but how did you get the analytics bubble boy?
There is a feature in Solr called Facets, which groups, is somewhat like group by what you could call it, Excel.
And then you have Google Maps, and what's the JavaScript?
Yeah, so JavaScript only. Actually, we are not using Google's own markers because they had some problems. And we could not put large amount of text, like these bubbles are bigger and these are smaller. So everything is custom done, it's an overlay on top. We are using x and y coordinates to plot it on the map. We are we are considering it now after.
Which means this guy has something. Yeah, I was wondering how you guys did the marker clustering. Is that part of the Google Maps API, or you guys?
No, the markers are all written by us, all custom.
Right, the clustering. How does the clustering happen?
That's what he said. Solr
does that. Solr is a Lucene-based application.
Do you actually use the lat log to figure out, you know, things like stats like how far it's from the airport or something like that? Typically people lie about those things, right?
We're not doing that now, but like map search version 2 is still in the pipeline, and we have a lot of features planned.
That we got to disclose then. One of the listings you defined was in Koramangala, it's at 30 kilometers from the airport.
Home Shikari, not used it so often, but I've just seen it once. They normally use a radial search, like they actually use geohashing. So they only show the listings within that area. I'm not really up to compare them.
So I'm still in the process of finding a place for myself. And
I use this because it helps me see, even in my area, I can see that.
No, thing is, I do have an account on Common Floor, and the only thing that I get from Common Floor is that.
I think the other thing about this is that, you know, one of my cousins had come from Bombay and was searching all over the place between Koramangala and Indranagar. And the really good houses, they say, don't get listed anywhere. So,
that's not something we can take
care of. That's our problem, I guess.
Any other questions?
Yes. Thank you.